Well, guys, here we go. We're going to try to get this motor attached to this engine to this bell housing tonight. And I hope this slides in there somewhat respectably. So, got to come my way just a little bit. Reset here. Sorry guys, not very talkative. So close, man, that's just not fair. That is just not fair. It doesn't look bad right there. Thank you. whoops. Alright guys, so we are just a little high right there, so we're going to let this side down just a little bit more. There's our pin. Well, gotta get my little bar, be right back. All right, guys. Oh, that's not fair. Alright, so I let that down just a little bit. Boy, it just doesn't want to behave, does it? Guess it always ends up like that on occasion. Looks like everything is finally lined up. Okay. That looks pretty good, guys. I'm gonna do the other side. Okay. After a lot of work, we have a tractor again.
man, guys. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, serial number 8100 has a good motor back in it. Alright. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to check our engine to make sure it turns over. Yep. Gonna come back here. Clutch feels good. We'll give that an adjustment. So, where are we headed next? I am now going to put in my parts order. Or actually, no, this is Wednesday. I've already done that. Sorry. I know I had Monday off, but it already feels like a long week. So I have the new gasket for the water jacket and the cover coming. I haven't located a bowl for the carburetor yet. That manifold's going to have to do for right now. Maybe I cut that muffler or pipe off right there and weld something on. Maybe I don't. I ordered in new hoses and ordered in a new belt. And I got oil and filter already here at the shop. My next plan is to start with the basics for the engine. Points, plugs, oil, etc. We'll get our oil pressure gauge out of that tractor and bring it over here to save this one. We'll get our oil lines all hooked up right. We'll get our fuel line and our choke. And then the next big project is, what am I going to do about the radiator? Because both of the bolts in the Farmall H radiator bottom twisted off when I grabbed a hold of them. So, I know some people may disagree with this, but I have documented the condition of the original block for 8100. The neat thing about this engine is there's no number stamped where there should be a number stamped. I didn't recognize that, and I have sanded it and sanded it trying to find it. So it didn't fool me like it did last time. But I think half the battle is done here on trying to save 1939H, serial number 8100. And the other half of the battle is just going to be taking it from this to a running unit. That will be the next series of videos, depending upon how the weather goes this weekend. Otherwise, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry there wasn't a lot of commentary, but I tried to keep the swear words to a minimum. So have a good weekend. Enjoy. Hit like and subscribe if you want.